Hello and welcome to the Terrapura Non-League Show. Now the beast from the east put paid to a couple of episodes, call-offs, cancellations, bad weather, but we chose a place today where we knew we couldn't get a game called off. We're at Culver Road and we're going to bring you extensive highlights of Lancing versus Pagham. We actually covered this fixture last season and that ended up being a 3-1 victory for the visiting team. It's family day here for Lancing. Yep, a child, paying child. Means that adults come free. Sounds like a great idea. It should happen every day at a football ground. We'll find out what happens though in the game later on in the show. So I did mention that it is family day here at Culver Road, and if you just look to my right and to your left, a strange family have joined us from another galaxy. Yes, stormtroopers joining us here for Lancing versus Pagham. Judging by the whiteness of their colour, I can't work out who they're supporting, but let's hope they're here for the Lancers. Anyway, we'll bring you all the action and highlights later on in the show. Here we are then, ahead of the kickoff, a couple of big changes for both teams, and for Lancing they're without the suspended Fenton and Lewis Finney, of course their top goal scorer, and they weren't helped with Alex Fair pulling out this morning, so a last minute pull out there, so that's left their team looking a bit on the short side. We'll go through De Cruz in goal, Watson, Marsh, Captain Bygraves, Sharman, Spinks, Benson, Williamson, Tradria, Robinson and Broughton. For Pagham, the big news coming out of there is that their top goal scorer, Simmons, is also out. He scored 16 goals in his past 10 games. He joined the club just before Christmas and has already amassed 26 goals. He is the league top goal scorer. Now, he's not in the team, so leading the line will be Parkinson and Rowlett, their second top goal scorer, Overton, who's got 23 goals in total this term. He's only on the bench, and I wonder if that's because they've got one eye on the Sussex Senior Cup semi-final, which will be played here on Tuesday night. They're playing Brighton Hove Albion under-23 team. We covered this game last season. Lancing took the lead in that game and then actually held the lead at half-time before succumbing to a 3-1 defeat. But Lancing are, in fact, only one of three clubs that have stopped Pagham from scoring. High scoring Pagham have scored 71 league goals, the league top goal scorers. And that is amassed nearly three goals a game. They're still with an outside chance of putting a title front together there. 10 points off the top of the table, but they do have two games in hand on Horsham YMCA. So a win today, and they could find themselves right back in the mix for maybe winning the title and promotion to the Bostic League South. Chatting to manager John Sharman before the game, and it's been a difficult time. They've not been able to train because of the amount of games here at Culver Road, of course, with the weather, the beast from the east, putting paid to some games. Also, that is one of the few occasions where we've had games called off at this ground, and that's because it was unsafe around the ground for spectators, which is why there was a game called off here. That was a couple of weeks ago. So this is actually their fifth game of the new year, and Lancing are yet to win one. Four defeats on the spin for the Lancers. In fact, it's five if you go to the tail end of last year. An important foot in there stops Lancing. A challenger appeals for a free kick, waved away. Williamson, nice twists and turns from the midfielder. Referee waves advantage and he pops one up to Tradria, who scored that goal when Lancing won at Nye Timber Lane at Pagham. 1-0 victory, which really caused a bit of stir. It's when Lancing were on a bit of red hot form. It's one of only six defeats that Pagham have suffered this season. And Tradria is the man who is leading the line, who got that goal. Williamson playing quite an advanced position. That should be dealt with and is at the back by Van Driel. And he allows Binfield to get his first involvement in the game. Plays one long. Well watched by Bygraves. Scored a lot of goals recently with Pagham. Very much one of the form teams. Marsh getting in there and then spreading in, and it's Tradria, he could get in, but Binfield comes out well. He's managed to keep his clearance in play. Marsh has to put the ball out. always in and around the business end of the table in this division. It's an easy one for De Cruz to come and claim. Marsh wanted him to roll out and he still wanted it. De Cruz puts the hand up, acknowledges. Chatting earlier on, they want to get a feel for the love of the game again here at Lancing. On a bit of poor form. Certainly safe as far as the table's concerned, very entrenched in mid-table. Sitting 12th. And they're a good 10 points clear of the drop zone. And do have games in hand, but one thing with Lancing this season, and indeed last season, they don't draw many games. Only drawn two of their 26 league games this season. Nice ball forward there from Davidson. What a space to turn for Rowlett. Oh, it's an intelligent run and an early chance. Great goalkeeping from De Cruz coming out, smothering that attempt. But suddenly the Lancing defence parted and Andy Chick ghosted in between. But brave, alert goalkeeping from De Cruz keeps the score level. In 5 minutes. Is that an early warning sign, an early test? Hold up play there from Parkinson with his back to goal. Couldn't keep possession for his team though. Watson has got time to pick a forward pass. Making things difficult for Wiggins, the back. Pagham, patient now, kept keeping possession of the ball. And now there is space, and lots of space out on this near side for Wiggins. The ball does eventually reach him. A free man at the back post, instead it comes in short. Lewis just shows a bit too much, and Marsh mops up. And Sharman can get the ball clear. Tredrier's got a run. Davidson, strong at the back. Leading by example. Play starting to come into the Lancing half more and more. As Parkinson looks to get in on the act. Look to launch a counter-attack and Tredria. He's got a bit of pace on him. But the ball also had a bit too much pace on it and rolls all the way through to Binfield. Both goalkeepers had to be alert at the early stages of this one. Davidson, ball up, held by Parkinson, and goes back to his skipper. Nice quick, crisp passes from Pagham. Davidson just had to check and rethink his pass, but Pagham maintained possession. A nice run in behind here from Rowlett. He gets an early crossing. It's cleared away by Bygraves. Haven't been able to even train for the last few weeks. Played only four games in, well, already in the 10th week of the year. It's pressure, too much pressure from Rowlett. Brings down Spinks. Lancing able just to slow down the tempo of the game. I can tell you that the Burgess Hill Leatherhead game is called off today. Waterlogged pitch. Chip ball forward. It's just too much on Williamson. It's cleared away, but only back as far as Sharman. He played the initial ball through. Marsh gets bundled to the ground. We still carry on. Marsh just deflects that one away from Lewis. Still, Pagan putting on the pressure. Here's Rowlett. Sensible ball back to Chick. And now Bingham. He's just let the ball run away with him. Gets a shot. And that's not far away wide. He managed to fashion the shot. Had enough power, not quite the accuracy. Once again, Lancing get on with the game quickly. Chip ball forward from Sharman. Here's Marsh. Tradria makes the run into the channel. Richardson's got to be alert, and he is. And he almost played his team into trouble, but Bingham was comfortable in the situation. Spinks did well to recover, and Marsh looks to carry the attack forward. He's got Broughton on the outside. He looked to check in. That pathway was slammed shut. Sharman with time to pick his pass. And Robinson. Lancy now getting a feel for the ball. Nice tussle over on that far side. Benson is felled. Good hold up play from Thurger. And a deep cross. Here's Lewis. He gets his head to it. And it was shielded away by the captain, Bygraves. We call that a nearly moment. Chick goes jumping in, didn't come away with it. Now Williamson just comes off his head and coming back to win it is Rowlett. Here goes Thurger, he's got options ahead of him. And that was an important head, just took it out of the path of Lewis. And Marsh can bring it forward. It's kept in play by Broughton, who just thinks with his left and pops his foot in it. Tradier, clever first time layoff from him. Lansing keeping possession, playing well under pressure. It was time there for Spinks to turn. Instead, he elected to go back to his captain. Of course, his Sharman alongside him, who's deep at the moment. He's just stepped up, and Lewis has timed his run to stay onside. Marsh marshalled him well. I'll say Dave Sharman is the record appearance holder for Lancing. He overtook his father and current manager John's record earlier this season. Now it's just a question of how many games he'll play. Players hurt. That's a strong challenge from Bingham. Nice quick feet from Broughton. He's still going, twisting, turning, gets his shot away. And earns a warm round of applause from the crowd for his efforts. Skills of Broughton just didn't quite get enough on that one. And Lansing, talking about their form, they haven't won a game here since the 16th of December against Crawley down Gatwick. And free kick given there against Williamson. They've also conceded at a rate of exactly two goals a game, which has been something of concern. They've been hit, certainly at the start of the season, with a lot of injuries to their defensive line, as De Cruz couldn't keep that one in play. Or even in the ground, it's gone over to the flats over on that far side. Works it down then. Lewis gets away from Marsh for the first time in this game and then picks a crossing. That's too close to De Cruz, and he'll comfortably grab that one. And now Lansing leader foray into Pagham half. It doesn't last too long, although Tradria held off Richardson. Then plays an intelligent ball through. There was a pass on there. Just feeling his shins roll it. Must have caught a little challenge there. He's back on the ball now, though. And now he brings in Booker. He gets his pass up to Thurger. And Pagham patiently looking for an opening. Hopeful the goals will come. Sharma note steps in and stops that attack. Once again, Tradria, target man up top, laying off, bringing others into the game. Spinks is allowed to turn and spreads a delightful ball over to that far side. Benson gets to it and keeps it in play. Now he needs support. It's a deep one. Confusion in the box, and is it turned away? It's a free kick given at the end of the day. Not quite sure what for, but a nearly moment for the Lancers. Best moment of the game so far, that Williamson overhead kick. And De Cruz coming out to smother an attempt by Parkinson. For Pagham, that is. Not much between the two teams in this stage. You do wonder how much that game, that semi-final game against Brighton Hove Albion on Tuesday night, will play on the minds of the Pagham players. Davidson wanting support. Thurgood throws himself to the ground and doesn't get a free kick. Nice back heel, and that will be a free kick on Williamson. Foul by Bingham. Not much to get the Stormtroopers excited at the moment in this one. Here's Benson with his back to goal, and he's got it through the legs of Andrill. And then, I thought it was a little bit of afters there, but that was a bit unnecessary. Benson just threw the ball into the midriff of Thurgood. Referee Dominic Barrett just having a word with the Lancing number seven. Schick tried to make something of that, but Bygraves was there. And just Bingham pulled out of the challenge there. Referee plays advantage. It's Broughton can carry it forward. Spinks with a chance to get a cross in. He's right on the byline. Has to settle for the throw. It was Spinks' run. Fashioned that chance in the first place. Marsh with a nice looking ball. Benson wasn't there on the end of it, and now Pagham can break, and Chick juggles the ball forward. Thurgood takes over. He's forced to go all the way back to Van Drill. And here's Bingham in space. He's had one side to a goal. And the first one is in a very similar position to his earlier effort. But he's got a powerful shot on him, the number six for Pagham. Now Sharman plays it out to this near side. Spinks plays it forward. And Williamson up to Tredia. He's making a nuisance of himself up on that back line of Pagham. Davidson and Booker not getting any time to rest on the ball. Here is Davidson, and Williamson came flying in, and there's Tredia. Captain just about gets away with it. As I said, not many teams have stopped Pagham scoring this season. Lancing are one of only three in the league. As Lewis looks to take on Marsh, and Marsh is strong. It's a bit of a wrestle between them, and Lewis comes away with the ball, and he gets a low cross in by Graves. It comes off his foot. It could have gone anywhere. And thankfully for him, it's gone the right side of the post and only out for a corner. So corner then. Curled in underneath. A free header for Davidson. Really should have done better. Seemed to just hang in the air. And Davidson had all the time in the world to pick his spot. He just got his angles all wrong. And Pagham should be ahead. And there's Sharman watching that one carefully all the way.
We'll have to defend again though. Here's Chick. The referee thought about blowing the whistle. He's now played advantage. Williamson come in. A theatrical fault, but a free kick against Rowlett. He's definitely seemed to be on his way down before the challenge came in. This really is a free kick in a good position for Pagham. Now the question is, will he try and catch the keeper out and go for goal? Or will he deliver a cross? Rowlett's made a little run off the ball there. It's easily dealt with and headed away. Nothing doing on that occasion. And now the referee will have a word with the Pagham man. The feeling this game's becoming a bit verbal. So, first yellow card of the game goes to Bingham, midfielder. Got pushed in the back of by Chick, but Rowlett's allowed to bring this one forward, and he's still going, and then he goes down and he buys the free kick. This is Lloyd Rowlett territory and an opportunity for a direct shot on goal. Rowlett, who's got eight league goals to his name. This is a six-man wall. Rowlett goes low. It's off to Cruz. And a little backheel to Cruz is there again. Parkinson with a backheel attempt. Didn't quite get enough on it. And de Cruz saves not once but twice. Rowlett is getting more and more involved in the game. Back to Lewis. Four men in a line around the penalty spot for Pagham. They've now had to jog back as Lansing have got back in position. Well, everyone behind the ball except Tradia, the lonely man up front. It's Davidson up to Rowlett. He's allowed to turn. He's thought about the cross, then plays it in, and de Cruz comes out, and Thurgood went charging into the goal and rocked it back about 2 foot behind the line. De Cruz is feeling that one. But he was strong, came out and won the ball. Both teams have been good in possession. Pagham potentially looked the more clinical in terms of fashioning a chance, but neither side have found a way to break the deadlock this first half. Sharman was forced to, as I say, back into his own corner, but he played his way out of danger brilliantly. That was too much from Robinson. Now Rowlett thinks about it. And that wasn't far away at all. That's Bingham. Nice little flick round by Parkinson. Rowlett. It's not allowed to go anywhere, so he has to play it into the channel to Parkinson. Just about keeps that one in play. Now he's looking for runners in the middle. Chicks beaten to it. And a flick headed by Spinks. Gets it away in. That's a nice turn from Robinson. And the offside flag up against Dredria. Tie hanging one for Dredria. It's beaten to it by Davidson. Rowlett with the flick on Chick. Lewis has made a great run over. And he's found. He just couldn't bring it under control. And Marsh got back to him. And that cross got all the way through to Thurgood. Parkinson on the edge. And Spinks does well in breaking up the play, and he just jumps into a Pagham man. And if that wasn't enough, he certainly made sure that Rowlett felt the force of that challenge. Chick. Booker gets a cross in. Rowlett! And there's a goal right on the stroke of half-time. They took the free kick out to Booker. Lansing weren't prepared. And Rowlett came across his man and gets a firm foot on it and places it past De Cruz inside that near post. And Pagham, they do always score, well, most of the time anyway, and they've got a goal here. And their number 10, who's been probably the liveliest player on the pitch, has got the goal. Lloyd Rowlett with his ninth league goal of the season gives Pagham the lead. It's Lansing 0, Pagham 1. Marsh watched that well, didn't allow Bingham in. And he brings the ball forward himself. Plays it to the opposite fullback, Watson. Turns into trouble. And that's the end of the action of the first half. It's been tight. A few chances for either team, but the deadlock broken right on the stroke of half time. A quick free kick. An unexpected free kick as far as Lansing are concerned. Booker with the delivery. And Lloyd Rowlett with the finish. And the half-time score is Lansing 0, Pagham 1. With Pagham, kick off the second half from right to left. They're currently sitting seventh. As I mentioned earlier, they are 12 points off the top. Do have two games in hand. And so they average nearly three goals a game, and they were without their two leading goal scorers, Simmons and Overton. Overton, who's on the bench. Of course, he scored here last season, we saw in the non-league show. And immediately they're on the attack with Rowlett, the scorer of that goal. Just caught Lansing short, an early cross. Has to be dealt with and is by Watson. Then hooked on by Williamson. And Van Driel come flying in to stop Benson on the attack. Wonder how on the front foot Pagham will be in the second half. Thurgood went to go in. And then he went flying in on Bygraves. He cleared the ball away. It's got a bit of something about in the number seven for Pagham. Chick just being held up on the byline. Thurgood gets a low cross in. No one in a white shirt there on this occasion, but that's given away. We've seen Bingham hit one from there a couple of times in the first half. And also that man, Rowlett, got strikes on him. Lewis eventually gets the better of Marsh. His cross doesn't beat the first man. There's all Pagham pressure to start this second half. A drag turn from Wiggins. That's just a misdirected pass up towards Thurgood. And Benson immediately goes on his bike. Van Driel leaves that one to Booker. Benson gets the first time crossing. It's just ahead of Tredia, but coming in on the opposite side was Broughton. Robinson back to Marsh, and now Spinks able to turn. Better this from Lansing. Now everyone, Varda Cruz inside the Pagham half, just looking for a way through. A little step over, gets towards the byline. Tredia, his shot was blocked. Fine work from Broughton on the far side. And Lewis immediately pings one over for Thurgood. He's trying to hold off Watson. Quite literally and figuratively. Again, he's getting involved. Sharman looks to pop one forward. Marsh had made a forward run. And here he is, winning the ball back in an advanced position. And then he gets in between two Pagham defenders. And the offside flag stays down against Tredia, who's still going. And I think, yes, he had run out of play. Marsh there, ghosting between two challenges before feeding the ball through to Tredia. I'm also hearing that Lewis took a lead into the break. And it's a shot from distance. Oh! Was that tipped onto the bar? It was. De Cruz with a great save. Pushed onto the bar. And that was Thurgood unleashing his frustration, his anger on that strike. He got everything behind it. But De Cruz stood tall and was equal to it.
Headed away at the near post by Williamson. Chick. Clever ball out to Roller, who takes it down on the chest. It's forced to go back to Chick, who picks out Lewis in the far post. Keeps the attack alive. And here's Booker. De Cruz down. Gathers. Booker didn't really get hold of it, to be honest. Here goes Thurgood. Charging forward. Gets a low cross in. Parkinson gets half a foot to it. Lewis. Good save at the near post by De Cruz. It's almost a miss hit from Parkinson. And it turned out to be a good ball for Lewis. Chick. Curls a nice ball out. And eventually it works through to Thurgood. He just took a touch and gets an early cross in. Parkinson just pulled away from his marker. Looking to get on it. Back with Chick. A big line ahead of him. And that one skimmed through and it wasn't far away at all. De Cruz confident though. He had it covered. Thurgood's just pulled away at the back post. It's again high and hanging. De Cruz gets two fists on this one and it's away. And now Benson can lead a break. And Rowlett was there again. He's got a way of throwing himself to the ground though. Not saying it wasn't a free kick, but he knows how to make the most of it. But that's where Lewis, Lansing do look dangerous. They've got the ball in those wide positions and the opposite winger coming in off the flank. Bygraves has to get that one clear and Tredier got a push in the back. Booker was clever with that one. Benson plays one. The offside flag went up there and that seemed quite tight. Ball did end up in the back of the net, but a few disgruntled Lansing fans next to me there. Not so sure the decision was right from the assistant referee. An honest challenge in the middle of the park. Breaks Spinks' way. Here's Marsh. Put his foot on the ball and picked out Spinks. Here's Broughton. Now three yellow shirts in the middle. He just showed too much of it to the fullback and that attack broke down. Too much on the ball. And Lansing continued the attack with Marsh. Spinks with a man on, but just checks inside and then goes down. Gets a free kick. It's a soft hanging leg out from Bingham. Tredria looked like he wanted to get involved. He's been shooed away. Let's curl towards goal and it's just over the top. Not a bad effort at all. Williamson gets the ball back for Lansing though and is looking for runners. Back with Williamson. He's got Watson on this near side up against Van Driel. Instead he comes back to Spinks. Nice, clever show of foot and then he drops his shoulder and goes. He's still going, but he's going to run out of pitch. He's frustrated with himself. It was a good run from Spinks. Should have a mention about another non-league club that are in trouble, although they're not from Sussex's Dulwich Hamlet and their plight. And it's been great seeing football clubs around the country getting involved in helping, not least their main rivals Tooting & Mitcham, which have offered them a ground to play their remaining home fixtures this season. And Benson gets a cross in and it's Williamson came sliding in. Spinks. Space for Robinson. Tredria turned. The ball bounced kindly for him. But his shot came off of Wiggins. Comfortable for the keeper, who's making sure he takes as much time as he legally can. Marsh for Lansing. Doesn't change anything for them. So maybe a bit of pace That's central position. That's a strong challenge. And there's a injury there. And that looks nasty for Bingham. He just got his... He came flying in. Seemed to get his studs caught in the turf. Just a little bit scrappy. That's strong from Tradia against Chick. Who then goes flying in. And that should be a... Well, it is a free kick. Just wonder if the referee's going to take any more action. He's not. He's quite content to let play go. Any time he's given a yellow card was for dissent. Lancing go again. Experienced head Charmant plays the ball forward. Nice quick feet there from Broughton. He's still going and plays it through for Williamson. First time I thought he'd broken the back line. He's still going now. It's being held up by Killams. Finds Watson. First time ball down the line to Benson. Deep cross to the back post. Headed away by Booker. And then by Wiggins. Chick under pressure. Plays up to Thurgood. Holds off his man well. That's a lovely calm ball to Horncastle. He looked at play the killer ball through to Chick. Soft appeals for handball from the Pagham bench over on that far side. Benson just allowed to drop the shoulder and he's got the pace to keep that one in play. It's got behind Van Driel and now he takes a touch to settle himself. It's low cross turned away at the near post by Booker. And then Lewis takes a chance. Watson wins it off him. And he's still going, Watson. He thought about the shot and eventually he did. Williamson. Oh, he tried to pick out Tradia. Just deflected away from him and Tradia looks to the heavens and asks why. Why didn't it just break for me? No, a real chance for Lancing. Whipped in, flicked on by Wink Spinks. And a second time volleyed across, turned away again by Davidson. Who was there not once but twice. Nervy moments for Pagham. That corner curled away from the keeper just over the head of Bygraves. Tradia will keep it alive. Nice, clever chip. Back to the captain by Graves. Doesn't get enough on it. Comfortable for Binfield. He looks long up towards Thurgood. Watson's back there. Watches it all the way. Now Lancing can't clear their lines. They want a free kick and there is a free kick. Marsh came in from behind. He eventually got the ball after getting tangled up in the legs of the substitute. Killam. Van Driel. Ball hits the wall. Horncastle. Intelligent ball back to Van Driel. And then chips one over the top. Jim Killam, who's still going. And then he's brought down, and that will be a yellow card for Bygraves. Cynical foul from the captain. And he's the first Lancing player to go into the book. All's not lost just yet. Marsh. Looks long, five yellow shirts at the top and Davidson and the whites, the captain, got there first. Lancing can't find a way through. Maybe they can. Davidson certainly pulling the shirt. The referee saw that. It was pretty clear. And both captains go into the book in quick succession. Tradia leaves it for Spinks. No, it is going to be Tradia who plays it through to Spinks. He gets a cross in. It's deflected. For Lancing player will be a goal kick. Williamson could bring that one down. Showed a bit too much of it, but got there ahead of Chick. Davidson again, bullish coming out. Williamson certainly played well today. Marsh, though, delivers it. Davidson again. It's like a magnet, the ball sticking to him. Marsh's cross is blocked and Rowlett, the goal scorer, plays it up to Thurgood. Charmant holds him off initially. Thurgood, though, is just going to run it down into the channel. Waste some valuable time. And he wins the throw. And now a yellow card for Charmant. We're at the end of stoppage time, thrown towards Thurgood.
does well to hold up the play and keep the ball in the corner.
And then free kick given against the number seven. De Cruz to Williamson. There's no more time. They couldn't find a way through in the second half, and Pagham hold on for a crucial 1-0 win in their outside chance of a title fight. A few bookings for dissent, but a generally well-played competitive game. One moment where the Lancers switched off, they were punished right on the stroke of half-time. Rowlett's goal separates the two teams. It's finished here, Lancing 0, Pagham 1.
Very pleased with them, Oz. It was, you know yourself, that we had a lot of players missing today, but it was good team spirit. They gave it a go on the pitch to their best, and we just need that little bit of luck. You know, we didn't create much, to be honest, up front, but they gave it their best shot. I think Pagham would have expected to come here, roll us over after looking at our last half dozen results, really. So, I'm very pleased with what's gone on, and hopefully we can push on from that now. Kept down on the pitch there, had a quick word with them to let them know how well they'd done. I said to them before the game, you know, it's putting a good performance. It doesn't matter who's here, who's not here. Get out there, give it the best shot. And then Tuesday we'll go again. It's given me, you know, selection issues that it's nice to have for a change. But no, I thought they gave it a good shot and did well. I had a word with them at the end and I said, you know, these bookings, that last booking, why was that? And he said, dissent for the linesman. I said, well, it was clearly our throw anyway. The linesman had made a mistake. And I said, you let all these tackles go and all these other incidents go right from the sort of like second or third minute. Why is it always at the end of a game you start flashing cards? I said, everyone heard one of the players call you a certain thing. Nothing's done about it. And they just say the usual, I never heard it. I don't see it. So it is frustrating. It's a difficult, you know, they've got to, you know, run the game as best they can. It's not that easy. You don't always see eye to eye with the players or management. But, no, it's frustrating. But, yeah, there are some tackles there that, you know, studs showing are dangerous tackles. And others, I know Bygraves made a foul, committed the foul at the end there. It wasn't a dangerous tackle. He just brought him down to stop play, really. It's frustrating, but there you go. Yeah, it'd be nice to have a consistent team, you know. It's not everyone's available. One week you think, great, getting everybody back, the game's postponed, and then the next game there's four or five missing. You want to pick your strongest side, but there again, you know, perhaps are the best players your strongest side. It's not always the best players that make the best team, but there are some players to come back in. I think that will strengthen us. I think we need to create a little bit more and just need that little bit of luck, I think.
Brilliant. Well, thanks very much, and happy family day.
Yeah.
So there we have it then, the end of another Terrapura non-league show. Not quite the thriller we were hoping for and expecting at the start of the game, but certainly a good battling performance for Lancing, although they'll be disappointed that they didn't take victory or even a point from a game against a very good Pagham team who maybe had one eye on the Sussex Senior Cup semi-final this coming Tuesday. We'll be back, same place, same time next week. We hope to see you there on Latest TV, 7 p.m. on a Monday night.